The construction continues here at the Sky Pod, guys. Never ending talaga. Parang nagiging hobby ko na to dito sa bahay. But this will be a laundry area kasi mainit daw sa loob yung current laundry room namin. This one. So, outdoor laundry area, and this would be an extra bedroom, and then may CR pa kaming gagawin dyan. But more updates on that later. Meron pa kaming mga ginagawa na iba. We're also repairing all the wood that was damaged from Typhoon Odette, so nire-repaint namin to. Ito yung mga superheroes ng painting. Hi guys! But our topic for today would be that one. We have started installing our solar panel systems. And this will essentially cover the entire, hopefully, entire electricity bill of our whole house. The panels here I got from a company called Jinko Solar. I'll put links down below to where I got them. I got them from Mauning. And we have even more panels to be installed. Meron pa dito. And this will all be included in our solar system. So, kasama na battery, kasama na yung mga inverters. So, solar is fairly complicated, but it doesn't have to be, at least the gist of it, at least from a homeowner's perspective, madali lang siya intindihin. So, that's my mission for you today. I'm gonna answer all the solar questions that most of you have asked me on Instagram. So for example, magkano yung cost, ano yung ROI, ano yung safety nito when it comes to typhoon, meron ba mga maintenance na kailangan? That's our video for today. I'm gonna make it my mission to make it as simple as possible. This video is sponsored by PDAX or PDAX. What I'm trying to do with my YouTube videos, yung pag-simplify ng mga technical terms to make sure everybody understands it. PDAX is doing it for cryptocurrency. So, they are a cryptocurrency exchange, and what's good about them is that they're licensed by the Banco Central ng Pilipinas. They have various security measures to make sure that you're safe when it comes to trading online. But yung favorite feature ko is that they accept Philippine peso, so hindi mo na kailangan mag-convert-convert pa because they are a homegrown cryptocurrency exchange. But alam naman natin na all these cryptocurrency things are very scary and very hard to like absorb. So ito yung sinasabi ko na PDAX is trying to do the exact same thing. Introducing PDAX Prime. So PDAX Prime is a service within PDAX that allows you easy and convenient access to the crypto market. PDAX Prime also gives you access to 50 tokens. This means that they can set you up with a trader on your preferred channel. So pwede kayong mag-message on Telegram. And this trader will give you competitive pricing, execute your transactions for you, so you can trade your tokens a lot easier. These are people that you can talk to and ask anything about crypto, and they will help you on your crypto journey. So sila na yung mag-simplify all these complexities about cryptocurrency. And they also give you access to learning content. So they have mga Zoom webinars and discussions with crypto experts. They teach you everything you need about cryptocurrency. So if you're interested to learn more about cryptocurrency or PDAX and PDAX Prime, you may download the app nila. I'll put a link down below. Or you can upgrade to PDAX Prime by emailing prime@pdax.ph. Plus, if you want 50 pesos worth of Bitcoin when you sign up, free lang, just use my name, Slater. Enter it as a code. So check them out, guys. So a few months ago, I actually made a video about generators and how to choose the right generators in your home. I'll put a link down below to that. And it was fairly well received, aside from a few comments saying na, oh, if you have solar, hindi mo na kailangan mag-generator. It might be true, but most of the time, it's not true. So let me explain a little bit. So imagine that this is your house. And ito yung nagsosupply ng power sa bahay natin, whether it's Meralco or kung sa Cebu, Veco. And you want to put a solar system. Solar system? A solar setup. So there's three general types of solar setups. The first would be a grid-tied solar setup. So you have your house, this is your house, and you still have the power from the main electricity provider, and you have your solar panels. This essentially connects to your home and helps it feed the light, thereby saving you a little bit of the consumption here. But if the solar panel does not get any sunlight, hindi niya matutulungan yung bahay mo. Meaning, this is a way only to save electricity. You can't use this as a generator or a backup. Basically, you're targeting around 30% to 40% savings on your home electrical consumption, and this would only work during the daytime. That's the very, very simple explanation of a grid-tied system. But imagine if meron pa rin akong supply from the main line, meron pa rin akong solar panel, but nilalagyan ko ng battery. Well, ito na yung tawag natin na hybrid system. So in this system, you can have power from the main line, and kung may solar panel ka, natutulungan din. And yung solar panels mo, nag-charge din ng batteries mo. So just in case this gets cut off, I can still power the light using the battery. And I can also use the battery at night when there is no sunlight hitting the solar panel. So with the hybrid setup, pwede mo tong gamitin as your emergency backup power. Just in case, napuputol talaga yung kuryente when there's blackouts, or in our case, and this is why we chose the hybrid system, when there's like a calamity like Typhoon Odette. So this is very, very important for us. That is a hybrid system. But what about the last system? The last system you have to choose from is the off-grid. Basically, tanggalin natin tong main line. It's all powered by the sunlight and the battery now. Bigger solar panels most likely, and bigger batteries most likely. Lipat muna tayo dito guys, kasi si Scotty umiiyak sa labas. Okay, let's talk about cost. Basically, I have this certain calculation, a ballpark figure lang. At least you would know how much a solar setup would cost you for your specific use case. So, when you're talking about a grid-tied setup, yung solar panel and your home lang, walang battery, all you need to do to know the cost of that system for your specific home is get your monthly bill and multiply it by 0.3, or around 30%. And then, you multiply it by 60 months. So that's around 5 years mo mababawi, or ROI. So for example, yung monthly bill ko is 10,000. I multiply it by 0.3, I get 3,000, and times 60, I get 180,000 pesos. That's a ballpark figure of what I should spend for my home. So in essence, a grid-tied, yung walang battery, would save you around 30% of your electrical bill every month. Actually, it's about 30 to 40%. And the ROI should be around 4 to 5 years when you're outsourcing the contractors. Of course, mas mura if you do DIY, if you know what you're doing. But for most of us, we get subcontractors, so that's the rate. For me personally, I feel like it makes solar panels very much feasible. If you think about yung pera mo, kung lalagay natin sa banko, magkano lang yung interest. When you're talking about a 5-year ROI, you're talking around 15% interest. So, mas effective pa rin to than just placing your money in the bank. Lagay na lang natin dito sa ating solar panels. Diba? Okay, so, what if hybrid system? Yung system namin dito sa bahay cost us almost 2 million pesos. And it's all because of the battery. And it's because you have to add a lot more solar panels. Because mag-feed siya ng battery and mag-feed din siya ng bahay mo. Especially when you want the entire house to be battery powered. Pwede ka naman talagang pumili na, oh, yung ilaw lang namin yung battery powered just in case of emergency. Pwede rin yan. But for our setup, it's 100% zero bill yung target namin. So basically, to compute what you should expect to pay for a zero bill hybrid system like ours, you would be taking 100% of your bill because you're trying to make it zero. 100%. So, yung 10,000 example natin kanina. And you multiply it by 96. So, if 10,000 yung bill mo, I'm scared for the number. 1 million pesos. Around that price range for a full hybrid system. So, there are two types of hybrid systems, I would say. One would be yung battery is good enough for the essentials, just in case may blackout. It can power the lights, the outlets, or you can have, like us, a full home hybrid. I don't know the technical term, but basically, yung buong bahay namin, naka-battery, meaning pati yung aircon, pati yung mga oven, yung mga big ticket items, because we wanted zero bill. We're not doing this mostly for ROI. We're basically doing this because of Typhoon Odette, yung trauma namin. And also, we want to be a lot greener. So every time we turn on an aircon, parang yung feeling namin na, oh, we're not wasting the environment. Now, these can depend on many factors. Pwede rin tong mas mahal or mas mura depending on the batteries, the brands, etc. But this will give you a good starting figure. Now, when it comes to the batteries don't last forever. Typically, they're rated for 7 to 10 years, but make sure you're getting the lithium iron phosphate type. It's a little bit more expensive, but it should last a lot longer, and it's a lot safer when it comes to fires around the house. So I recommend that type. That's the newest technology ng battery. Okay, a few more things that you may want to know about these solar panels. I've gotten questions about typhoon proofing. Is it safe for typhoon? And if ano yung mga maintenance? Let's start with maintenance first. Essentially, it's maintenance free. You just leave it there and make sure they're clean so that it can absorb as much of the sun energy as possible. But that's basically it. And these last for up to 20 to 25 years. And just check your manufacturer. They usually give warranties from 10 to 20 years because they're fairly confident na it will last talaga. And when it comes to Typhoon naman, well, these panels are mounted on these racks right here. And essentially, those racks are bolted to the structure of the roof talaga. So if the roof doesn't fly off, your solar panels would most likely not fly off as well. But, a very big but, I would advise that you consult your structural engineer of your home just to be extra sure. And if you look at the panels themselves, they are fairly thick. Medyo reinforced na talaga siya. Meron na siyang aluminum dito that runs all the way there. So they are designed to take a beating. Not beating na ganyan-ganyan, but they are structurally designed din na kaya nila yung mga heavy wind loads. That's it for today, guys, but stay tuned and subscribe to this channel because we'll be doing a lot more content about solar panels. We've actually started installing all the batteries, and we have a little bit more work to do, but I'll keep you posted, and I hope you like this video, and I'll see you later.